Till now we have discussed what is Fraunhofer diffraction and what is Fresnel diffraction. So today we are going to study the difference between Fraunhofer and Fresnel diffraction in order to understand that why they are divided into two classes. So according to the first point, as I have said in the previous videos, that Fraunhofer diffraction's main character is that the distance from the obstacle should be infinite, and for Fresnel this should be finite. So I have written here, as you can see, the effective distances of source and screen from the obstacle are infinite, and for Fresnel the source and screen are finite distances from the obstacles. And the second point is, the wavefront meeting the obstacle is a plane wavefront. And for Fresnel diffraction, the wavefront meeting the obstacle is spherical or cylindrical. The third one, that is the angular inclinations are important. But for Fresnel diffraction, the distance of different points on the screen are important. This is because as the distance is infinite, so to get the diffraction pattern on the screen, we need to know the static angular inclination, and that's only when we can get the diffraction pattern on the screen. But for Fresnel diffraction, the distance of different points on the screen are important, because already they are at a finite distance. So when you get the diffraction pattern in the screen, the points on the screen are important. And the fourth one, that is diffracted light is collected by means of lens, because as I have shown in the previous video, that we use a convex lens in order to converge the image to form on the screen. That is why the diffracted light should be collected by means of lens, and this lens is convex. For Fresnel diffraction, diffracted light directly falls on the screen, because they are already at a finite distance, so no such lens is used. According to the fifth point, the diffraction pattern is an image of the source modified by the diffraction at the obstacle for Fraunhofer diffraction. And for Fresnel, the diffraction pattern is a projection of the obstacle modified by the diffraction. This means that for Fraunhofer diffraction, the image which you are going to get on the screen, it depends upon the obstacle. But for Fresnel, the image which you are going to get on the screen, it depends on the diffraction. That is how the light is passing through the obstacle. And for Fraunhofer, the last is, center of diffraction pattern is always bright. Because in Fraunhofer, I have told you that there can be single slit, multiple slit, or number of slit you need to use. So the center of diffraction should be bright. But for Fresnel, may be bright or dark depending on number of Fresnel zones. So what is this Fresnel zones? That is the path through which the light is passing through the obstacle and falling or forming a pattern of diffraction on the screen. We will discuss the Fresnel zone in the next video. I hope up to this it is clear to you. Thank you for watching.